الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، we were in the sifat al-aridah, right? And previously we've taken from the 11. How many sifat al-aridah were there? 11. From the 11 we took some of them, right? And the last one that we took was al-ikhfa, right? Today we're going to go into Al-Idhar. We're going to go into Al-Idhar. What does Al-Idhar mean in the Arabic language? What does Al-Idhar mean in the language? So in the language it means Al-Bayan. Bayan means to clarify. It's to clarify. Speech is to clarify, na'am. So it means Al-Bayan. Bayan means in Arabic language is to clarify something. When you speak, speech, what are you doing? You're clarifying what's within you. Are you with me, brothers? Well, idah means what? To clarify. So bayan and idah mean the same thing. Sah? What does bayan mean? Clarification. Na'am, wadih. When you read in the Quran, mubeen, what does mubeen mean? Wadih. Mubeen means wadih, something which is clear. Are you with me? Mubeen means clear, right? Kitabun, mubeen, right? Which means what? A clear book, right? Allah says in the ayah, وَمَا تَسْقُطُ مِنْ وَرَقَةٍ إِلَّا يَعْلَمُهَا وَلَا حَبَّةٍ فِي ظُلُمَاتِ الْأَرْضِ وَلَا رَطْبٍ وَلَا يَابِسٍ إِلَّا فِي كِتَابٍ مبين, clear, right? So the word al-bayan means what? Clarification and idah. Then idhar means to make something clear. The word idhar in the Arabic language, dhahara. Dhahara means what? It became clear. Istilahan. What does it mean according to the scholars of the scholars of Quran? When they say al-idhar, what does it mean to them? It means ikhraj kullu harfin, is to bring every letter from where? Min makhrajihi, from its makhraj. Min ghayri ghunna, no ghunna. Because what does the ghunna do? It hides letters. It doesn't make it clear. Idhar, what does it want to do? It wants to make it clear. So ikhraj means every letter, it should come out what? It should come out clear. Wa inna allaha rabbi wa rabbukum fa'abuduh. Hada ziratun mustaqim. It's another qira'a, right? Zirat is another qira'a. You can read, it's another way of reading. Siradna is the way you read, sah? Sah? Hafs al-Asim reads like that. Khalaf reads as what? Hada zirat, zirat. Between, it's like a za sound. Huh? So it's to bring every letter. Inna Allah Rabbi wa Rabbukum fa'budu hada siratum must. All of that is what? Every letter is what? Every letter is clear. Kullu harf is what? It's clear. Ikhraju kullu harf. You bring out every letter from where, like in min? From its makhraj. Without any ghunna. How many letters? What are the huruf? Hurufuhu is what? How many letters does he have? 26 letters. How many letters? 26. Those 26 are other than? Ba cannot be in there. What else? Wow, Neem, and some scholars, the issue of fa. So it's ba, wow, and Neem. Other than those, whatever's left is a what? Other than those is, so it's ba, wow, and mim. Best. Are you with me? Some of the ulama of the qira'at, the concept of fa, but like in the fa, it doesn't come from the shafatain. It comes from the what? Batn al-shafa. That's another discussion. Okay. So it's how many letters? Three letters. What's the first one? Ba. Ba. Neem. Okay, other than those. So, إظهار لغة means البيان والإيضاح, إصطلاحا means إخراج كل حرف من مخرجه من غير غنة, without any غنة. How many letters did we say it has? We mentioned those, and in anything other than those three that we mentioned, which are the 26. So the 26 is what? The 26 are Al-Hamza, for example. So for example, أيهم أحسن عملا. التاء, for example, إنا أنزلناه قرآنا عربيا لعلهم, أم لعلكم, لعلكم تعقلون. لعلكم ميم, because ميم has سكون on it. تعقلون is behind, after it is what? It's a تاء. Yeah, so any is the ميم has سكون on it, and what comes after it? It comes after it any of the 26 letters. Now we're going to go into the next one, which is we're going to now go into al-mad. Al-maddu huwa italatu al-sawt. What does mad mean? Italatu al-sawt. It is to it's to elevate, it's to lengthen, prolong. Okay, itala, it's to prolong, make it long. As-sawt, the sound, biharfin min huruf al-mad, from one of the letters of what? From the huruf of mad. So the $1 million question is, صح, what are the huruf al-mad? That's the $1 million question, right? Hey, what is it? So it's waw, ya, and alif. In other words, you summarize it by saying why. Why is what summarizes it, yeah? So al-waw and al-ya and al-alif, these three letters are what? They're called hurufu? Hurufu al-mad. Together, all of them is why. Why? Waw, alif, ya. Why? Why summarize it for you? So remember it, okay? But the pay attention. Al-waw sakina. The waw has a sukun. Al-madmunu ma qablaha. After it is a what? Dhamma. So look, Yusuf. Al-ya al-sakina al-maqsuri ma qablaha. What does it have after it? It's got a sukun on it. Unais, listen. Al-ya al-sakina. The ya has a what? Sukun on it. And a kasra comes after it, which is like حكي حكيما. And الألف ولا تكون إلا ساكنة. It cannot be except with سكون ولا يكون ما قبلها إلا مفتوحا. And that which is before it cannot be except with what? So look at the word يوسف. The ya has what on it? The ya, what does it have on it? Yeah, but what does the ya have on top of it? ضمة. It has to have dhamma, which is you. So al-waw as-sakina. The waw has sukun on it, and before it is a dhamma. The ya has is sukun, and it's maksuru ma qablaha. What's before it? Haki, ki. Alif, as for the alif, it can't be except with sukun. Okay? And wala yakunu ma qablaha illa maftuhan. And that which comes before it has to be what? Maftuh. There's one verse in the Quran that has all three of them in there. It has what? All three of them. Nuhiha. Ha. Nuhiha. What does it have? It has all three of them in there. So nu, we have it here, right? Hi and ha. Are we all together? Wa'alam aydan. Also know. And then madda, that the mad is how many? Qisman is two types. The mad is what? The mad is two types. Mad asli and mad far'i. What is the mad asli? If you go to the kitab Muqaddimatul Jazariya, Al-Imam Al-Jazari doesn't talk about mad asli. He doesn't talk about it, which is known as also mad al-tabi'i. The mad asli is also called what? The mad asal is also called mad al-tabi'i. The mad al-asli, the mad asli Jazari does not talk about it in his nadm. He doesn't talk about it. He talks about which one? Mad Fara'i. He talks about, and what does it mean? The mad, it doesn't come after it, hamza or sukun. The mad asri. The mad after it, it doesn't come a hamza and a what? And a sukun. Now we're going to go into the mad far'i, because the mad asri is harakatan. How many harak is it? And it's tabi'i, it's natural. What is it? It's natural. So since it's natural, there's no need to talk about it. And Imam al-Jazari didn't talk about it, so we don't need to really talk about it. We're going to speak about which one? We're going to talk about the mad far'i. What are we going to talk about? The mad far'i. Okay, we're now going to speak about al-mad al-far'i. How many types of mad did we say there were? There were two types. Al-mad al-asli. And we said al-mad al-asli is what? It's also called? Al-tabi'i. Barakallahu feek. The mad al-asli is called also al-mad al-tabi'i. We said that al-imam al-jazari did not talk about that one. Lakin al-mad al-far'i is the one. They go in great details. المد الفرعي وأما المد الفرعي فله أسباب وأحكام وأنواع. Okay, pay attention to this. So, أسباب means what? Reasons. أحكام means ruling. And أنواع means what? It types. So the mad al-asli, sorry, al-mad al-far'i, it has asbab, reasons in why it happens. Wa ahkam, it has rulings. Wa anwa', it also has what? Wa anwa' means it has types. So it's asbab, which are reasons. Ahkam, which are rulings. Anwa', which are types. Those three are important that you learn it when you're studying المد الفرعي. فأما أسبابه, as for its أسباب, فهي اثنان, it's two. The reasons are two. What are they? الهمز and السكون. And we'll explain on that more details. اثنان, ها. We're going to come to it. فَأَمَّا أَسْبَابُهُ, as for its reasons, فَهِيَ ثْنَانِ, they are two. الْهَمْزَ and الْهَمْزَ, همزه. الْهَمْزَ and السُّكُون. Are we all together? Good. What does that mean? We'll go in great details, inshallah ta'ala. وَأَمَّا أَحْكَامُ, as for its ahkam, فَهِيَ ثَلَاثَةٌ, it's three. الْلُزُومُ وَالْوُجُوبُ وَالْجَوَازُ. What do they mean? We will go to that. Al-luzum. Al-luzum, luzum. Which means maddul lazim. Al-wujub and al-jawaz. These are the ahkam, the rulings that it goes through. وَأَمَّا أَنْوَاعُهُ فَيَ خَمْسَ. As for its types, there are how many? The mad. The maddul far'i. Five. Al-maddul muttasil. Al-maddul munfasil. المد البدل المد اللازم أنا المد العارض للسكون. Each one we will be taking in great details, inshallah ta'ala. Each one examples and things need to come out from it, inshallah. Does everyone so far understand that the مد الفرعي, the أسباب and the أحكام and the أنواع that I mentioned, crystal clear? كالشمس في رابعة النهار. I will stop there inshallah ta'ala for today. Next week we will go into great details in each one. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and his messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.